Hi there. Today we are going to look at the topic JSON. What is JSON format and what is it used for? JSON is short form of JavaScript Object Notation. That's a pretty big name, but the format is very simple and very useful. Let's take an example of a world where we didn't have a common language to talk to each other. English is predominantly considered as one of the common languages to talk within a country or across countries. Yet, many of them do not agree that English is the formal or official language, but just for argument's sake, let's take English as one of the common languages we all use to communicate with each other. In a world where suppose we did not even have English as a common language, let's assume an IT scenario where we have got application being built by the British guys, say it's in the UK. Now they are outsourcing this application to an Indian IT industry for maintaining and supporting it. And the end customer, the client of this application is Japanese. How do you think these guys can talk to each other? It will be very difficult for them to communicate with each other without a common language. And that is where English comes to a help, or any other common medium, or maybe a translator. But whatever it be, we need a solution to talk to each other. Now let's convert or translate this example into the various components in the IT industry or within side an application. How can these various applications or various platforms talk to each other? What is the common factor between them? And that is where JSON came into help. Let's take an example here. We have got a Java-based payment services application which is running on one of the environments. There is another inventory service which is written in .NET, maybe by another service provider, and is running on a different environment. Or it can be running on the same environment, doesn't matter. But the crux here is that the two backend services are written in different languages. One is in Java and one is in .NET. Now there is a web client or a website which needs to talk to both these services on the backend for various purposes. So for example, it's a website which needs to do payments and which also needs to get the data of the inventory, and hence it depends upon the payment service and the inventory service. Now how does this website talk to the payment service? It needs to have a particular language where the Java world understands, and it also needs to translate its request into another language which the .NET world understands. This way the client or the website becomes very complicated. It has to constantly identify to which platform it is talking to and translate its request accordingly. This is not a very ideal architecture. This is where JSON came into help, where instead of using language 1 or language 2 or any backend platform dependent language, we replace it with a common language for it called JSON. This way the website, irrespective of what platform the backend is written in, is talking in JSON format. Now what is a JSON format? You must have heard of XML formats, which was pretty complex, tag oriented. It had to follow a particular XSDs, etc. And it was pretty complicated. But JSON is very simple because it's textual and a readable format for structuring data. Primarily, JSON, as you could understand, is used for transmitting data between a server and its web application. And data is stored and transmitted as simple name value pairs. That's a JSON format. Now, there are some rules in writing JSON syntax. What are the rules? A data, as we said, is written in name value pairs. This name and value has to be separated using colon. The second rule is that each name value pair is separated by commas, because when you're trying to transmit a data from one source to the other, it's more than one data or values that you would want to pass. Each of these values are separated from each other using commas. Third rule is that one object, as we said, can have multiple name value pairs. To club or to signify or symbolize that these sets of name value pairs belong to one object, we wrap it within curly braces. And the last and the final rule for JSON syntax is the square bracket. When do you apply square brackets? That is, if you are trying to pass a list of objects from one source to the other, So one object is denoted by whatever comes within curly braces. But if you have many such curly braces or many such objects, you separate these objects with commas and wrap it around with square brackets, which becomes a list of objects. Now let's take these rules and see with an example. So first rule was name value pairs. They have to be colon separated. Let's take an example of a person. Suppose a website is parsing a customer's details to its backend, or a backend is trying to notify the frontend with the customer's details. And the detail involves the person's name, the age, and his height. The name value pair, as you can see here, is symbolized as name, colon, John, age, colon, 25, height, colon, 5'8". So this is data of one single person being passed to one source to the other. This object, so this applies the first rule, that is a name value pairs are separated by colons. Now let's see what's rule number two. Rule number two was each name value pair is separated by commas. So the first line, that is a name, the second line, which is the age, is separated via comma. The second value, which is the age, and the last value, which is the height, is separated by comma. So each name value pair is separated by commas. Now the third rule says to denote one object, we need to wrap these name value pairs in curly braces. So this becomes one object. This is an object or a person called John's detail, which we are wrapping in curly braces. The final rule was how to pass a list. So a list of such objects can be stored by separating each object by commas. So suppose we want to pass details of multiple persons from one source to the other. In that case, we see there are two objects here, one for the person called John and another for the person called Mary. For both of these objects, we are passing name value pairs for name, age, and height. Each of these objects are wrapped in their own curly braces, denoting that that is one single object. And each of these objects individually are separated by comma and wrapped inside a square bracket, showing that this is a list of objects, list of customer or a person object. So this is how we apply the JSON syntax rules to communicate between two applications. Now, there are easy ways to validate whether your JSON format is correct or not. For that, JSON itself has provided us with a website called jsonlint.com. If you go into this website and paste your JSON structure into that and press on validate JSON, it'll show you whether it is a valid JSON or not. I am deliberately going to introduce some error into this, what I've pasted in JSON A. So you can see that I have removed the comma between the two objects. And now if I validate, it'll clearly tell you that there is a syntactical error in the format that you have submitted. This way, you can always make sure that you have a well-formed JSON format. So that was a very simple video on what JSON is, what format it is, and where it is coming into use. For more related videos which makes use of JSON, please watch What is REST and What is Microservices. Bye for now.